Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, guys. Hope you guys are doing well.
Medina, Medina, Medina to Nabi.
This is a video to share my top 10 tips for you guys who are going to Hajj. Hajj season is coming up 2017, but this video will be up inshallah for all the future Hajjis. If you're going to Hajj for the first time, be prepared for the best journey of your life. I've got my phone here with all my tips in it, so excuse me if I'm going down on my phone. So, if you're going for the first time, alhamdulillah, it's amazing. If you're going for the second time, you already know how amazing Hajj is, subhanallah. This is my top 10 tips. They're not in any particular order, but the most important tip will be at the end, so stay tuned for that. The first tip is be organized before you travel. Check your passport, make sure it's valid for at least minimum 6 months. Liaise with your travel agent to make sure whatever the requirements are, you meet them. So may that be vaccines, may that be passports, and make sure you triple check your travel documents. I tend to have about 3 to 4 copies of all my travel documents, including my passport, my Hajj visa, and everything like that. So I make 4 copies. So if I'm going with my wife, I would give her 2 copies, keep 2 copies with myself, put 1 in my hand luggage and 1 in my main luggage. Again, she does the same, 1 in her main luggage and 1 in her hand luggage. And I also send all the electronic copies to my email and the wife's email, and also to relatives' email. So just in case my main luggage doesn't arrive, I've still got a copy in my hand luggage. Just in case that something happens to that, or just in case my passport goes missing, at least I've got all the electronic copies on my email. Make sure you have all your documents, your vaccines, all the certificates, everything ready. Number 2 is keep fit. So Hajj is very, very demanding spiritually and physically. So make sure before you travel, you are physically fit and you're spiritually fit. If you're overweight, try to cut down, try to eat more fruits and veg. Keeping fit with Hajj, you will walk miles and miles and miles. Make sure you get walking. If you're not much into walking, I would say get out and walk. Take your good trainers, good walking shoes with you and break them in. Break your slippers in, your sandals, your slippers, break them in. Meaning go out for walks. Make sure you're comfortable with them. Make sure they feel good on your feet. So get out and walk. Walk 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour walk. Because Hajj, you will walk. So keeping fit is very important. What you eat, what you put in your body is very important as well. Over in Hajj, Umrah, I did it myself. I indulged in so much rubbish. KFC, Hardee's, McDonald's, and burgers and burgers and chips and fries. At the time it was good, but it took an effect on my body. Drinking fizzy juice, drinking all that rubbish, full fat, fizzy, sugary drinks was horrible. So obviously, you've got all these outlets. You've got so many outlets of food, of drink. But what I would say, again, this is me just researching over the past year of what to eat, what not to eat, you know, healthy stuff. What I would say is keep fit, do as much walking as you can, and also start changing your diet. Start changing your diet from now, from today. Eat good vegetables, eat less, because the more you eat less, the more concentration you have. Eat the right foods, eat the right portion sizes, stay off the fizzy juice, stick to water, bottled water, not local tap water, and also drink as much zamzam as you can. Tip number 3 is packing. So before I go into tip number 3, link is in the description below for my packing video. Alhamdulillah, with Allah's blessings, it's helped so many people. Hopefully it'll help you guys. So link is in the description below for packing. Pack a lot of your stuff in the main luggage, but keep a backup in your hand luggage. Charger, one set of clothes, set of underwear, towel, toiletries. Again, they need to be under 100 milliliters as far as I know. So check with your local airline or airport or whatever. But keep essentials within your hand luggage, because if your main luggage goes missing, which happens, at least you're not stressed out. You've got one pair of clothes, you've got underwear and all that stuff in your hand luggage. So keep all the essentials in your hand luggage and pack as if your main luggage is going to get lost. Inshallah, I won't, but pack as if it's going to get lost. So at least if it gets lost, got your stuff in the hand luggage. Tip number 4 is very important. Know your Hajj. The amount of people who go to Hajj and rely on their organizers, their travel agents to tell them about Hajj. No, learn what Hajj is. Research Hajj. Don't go crazy into different schools of thoughts and all that stuff. That's what I did first time. I got confused. I was just thinking, whoa, this is too much. Hajj, learn your basics. Speak to your local imam. Say, imam, I have no idea about Hajj. I'm going for the first time for Hajj. tell me about Hajj. Most likely you'll be doing Hajj Tamattu. Research on that. So you do Umrah first, you change your clothes and then you relax for a bit and then you get prepared for Hajj. So that's Hajj Tamattu. Obviously there's so much more into it. So know your Hajj. Go to Hajj as if you know what to do. Research the dates and what you need to do in Mina, going to Arafat, the importance of Arafat, the importance of Muzdalifah, importance back to Mina, the Jamarat. Learn all that. Learn the basics of Hajj so you know that if your tour guide goes away or there's no lectures whilst you're in Makkah, then at least you know what's what. Have a one pager. Inshallah, in future, I'll be making the one pager. I won't have it up by this video, but inshallah, I'll make a one pager of roughly what Hajj is about, the days of Hajj. Also, definitely check out Project Hajj Nasiha. Link will be in the description below. Again, they're really, really good. I'm part of their project, but the brothers are doing a great, great job. So definitely check that out. So know your Hajj before going. So if anybody doesn't know their Hajj whilst they're there, you can explain it to them. Take pocket-sized books with you. Again, it'll help you learn, inshallah. You need to have confidence that, you know what, if I get lost, I know exactly what to do. I know exactly where to go. I know what's happening tomorrow. Tomorrow is Arafat. It's the most important day of Hajj. Know your Hajj. Number five, expectations. If you're paying for a five-star hotel, five-star package, expect the worst. Don't expect the best. It's going to be hard. It's going to be testing. You know, the reward for Hajj, you guys know, is that you finish with your slate completely clean. You finish like a baby. Allah wipes all your sins away. That's not gonna come if you have an easy Hajj. I'm not gonna pray for you guys for an easy Hajj. I'm gonna pray Allah accepts your Hajj. The hardships of Hajj are now are nothing compared to what we were back in the day. So, expectations. When I went to Arafat, I expected amazing spiritual levels, you know, just amazingness, all the Ummah get together and make dua, etc. No, it wasn't like that. I went and there was so much rubbish on the floor and I was like, literally walking in rubbish, and I was so disheartened that people were drinking cans of juice or water or throwing it on the street in the blessed lands of Arafat. Alhamdulillah, it was really, really heartbreaking for me to think that I had this expectation of gonna have this amazing day in Arafat, but nah, it was, I had to make it amazing. It was very hard. I had to get my concentration right. I'm here for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm here to make dua. I'm here to ask Allah to forgive me. I'm such a big sinner. I'm asking Allah to forgive me. Have mercy on me and my family. That's my goal for today. That's my goal for Hajj, is to please Allah and for Him to accept my Hajj. Expectations, expect the worst. If you expect the worst, things can only get better. So expect the worst. May that be a Hajj. May that be days of Hajj. May that be build up to Hajj. After Hajj, going from Makkah to Medina. Number six. Rest. Rest is key. People go very, very excited, go to Hajj, and what happens is they do so much between the week before Hajj. They do Umrah, they do multiple Umrahs, they do multiple Tawafs, they do so much walking. By the time Hajj comes, they're exhausted. Their legs hurt, they got cramps, they've got the flu, they got the cold, they got this and that. So my advice to you guys is rest. Rest as much as you can. When you go from here to Makkah to do Umrah, do your Umrah, I would say do at least one tawaf a day and rest. Sit down and just view the Kaaba, view the beauty of the Kaaba, because looking at the Kaaba is worship, subhanAllah. So rest as much as you can. Trust me, you will need all your energy come the days of Hajj. Number seven, focus on yourself. Hajj is packed full of people. Got people from all over the world. It's the best time ever, subhanAllah. But focus on yourself. Take some time out for yourself. Relax, take care of yourself, get yourself prepared for Hajj. Say, Ya Allah, I'm doing this for you. I am doing this Hajj for you, so I'm going to be taking my time. All the shopping and everything like that can be done in Medina, so have that confidence. Do zikr, get your heart ready for Hajj. Physically, as I mentioned, you get yourself ready. Make sure you get your heart ready for Hajj, because Hajj is the biggest journey of your life. Subhanallah. So focus on yourself. Read Quran. Do zikr. Remember Allah. Allah says in the Quran, from His remembrance do hearts find ease. So focus on yourself by remembering Allah, by doing zikr, by sending your salutations upon the beloved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So focus on yourself. Focus on your spirituality. Focus on getting yourself right before Hajj. You don't need to learn crazy amounts of ayats, crazy amounts of du'as. No, you can learn the basics. Remember Allah all the time. Remember Him. Read up on the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Read up on the beauty of the beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number nine is help others. For me, if somebody was to ask me, sum up Hajj in one sentence, I would say Hajj for me is helping others. For me, Hajj is helping others, being at the service of others. If there's elderly people in the group, which there will be, take care of them. Take care of them. Youngsters, take care of them as well. If you get a chance, and I would highly advise this, in Mina, get to know everybody, speak to everybody. If food is coming in, refreshments are coming in, help. Help push a wheelchair in your group. If there's elders in your group, give them company, give them time, help others, help anybody as much as you can. Again, do it with the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you and you're doing it for Him. In life, you should help others on a daily basis. But for Hajj specifically, I would say help others, be at service of others. And the last and final tip is the biggest tip, the biggest advice I can give you guys is have sabr, is have patience, have sabr. One of the biggest things that will get you through Hajj is having sabr. I see a lot of people prepared, get everything done, but when it comes to the time, they don't have the sabr. They break, they crumble, they start arguing with people, they start fighting with people. My dad told me once that once Hajj had finished, they were coming back to the UK, and people who had done Hajj, they were fighting with the other Hajjis over their seats. And it was getting so heated that it was about to go to physical fighting. So, have sabr. If you're an angry person, get on the zikr of Allah. Self-focus that Hajj is all about sabr. Have as much sabr as possible. If things are going wrong, your bag doesn't turn up, you don't get food on time, waiting for hours in Arafat or Muzdalifah, have sabr. One of the testing points was us from Makkah to Medina. It took us about 14 hours. And I enjoyed that. I enjoyed that. I said, look, well, however long it takes, alhamdulillah. Maybe if we got there quicker, if something would happen to us. Maybe, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting us through this test so we can pass this test and get more reward. Or He is avoiding us from big, big calamity. Have sabr. Be focused. Be positive. Have that mindset. You know what? Anything happens, I'm going for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is my protector. He's my creator. I'm going to be positive. I'm going to be pumped up. I'm going to be full of energy. I'm going to have so much sabr. I don't care. Nothing happens. Make dua. Oh Allah, give me sabr. Sabr and prayer will get you through Hajj. Have sabr. I can't explain how much sabr, how important sabr is. The key to Hajj is sabr, guys. Anyway, guys, that is my top 10 tips. Please like this and please, please, please share this video to everybody who's going to Hajj. Even if they've left for Hajj, send them this video and so they can watch it whilst they're in their hotel. Enjoy Hajj. Wallahi, when Hajj comes around, my heart, I get so emotional. Subhanallah. I get so emotional. I have a sad, sorrow feeling in my heart when Hajj comes around and I'm not going to Hajj. So you guys who've been to Hajj, you guys know exactly what I'm talking about. You guys who are going to Hajj for the first time, enjoy it. Enjoy it as much as you can. And guys, please, please, please keep me in your du'as. My name is Irfan. Please keep Brother Irfan in your du'as. Keep his family, his parents, his wife, his baby daughter, his whole family in your du'as. That's why I do this, is for your du'as. Please keep me in your du'as, especially on the day of Arafat. The day of Arafat is a whole different thing. The day of Arafat is the best day ever. So anyway, guys, Jazakallah khair for watching. Please spread this as much as you can. All the links will be in the description below, so check it out. Take care, enjoy your Hajj, and keep me in your du'as. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.